Yeah, Silas, you like try to peek around at Oriana's cuffs, and they have changed color from pink to like a very bright yellow, like a neon yellow.
The copycat like leans in and whispers "piss" to this guy.
I don't know. I wouldn't be laughing so much about piss colored handcuffs. You should chuck your own.
I'm not gonna.
All right.
Can Oriana see?
Yeah, Silas is gonna sit on their hands.
they're neon yellow.
Why neon? Why? It's so bright.
Gotta keep you safe at night. When the carriages are rolling around, they might need higher visibility.
Fantastic. Anyways.
Alright, you're probably all wondering why I gathered you here today.
Because we're under arrest?
Good job. You should do a thumbs up and pat on that. Good job. I don't have any more cookies or muffins, so I only got these today.
God, the right, only thing going to my mind right now is if Skvull was here, if you could handcuff her. If that'd be physically possible.
Probably not.
Because, like, well, here's the thing. This one has handcuffs on, don't they?
You can, like...
It is corporeal,
touch
though.
My copycat. Oh, it's like a thing.
The copycat's, like, physical.
Okay, I don't usually interact with the copycat in my defense.
I'll amend that soon enough. That is a threat. Don't say that part.
Oh, okay. That part
intended as a threat.
It's easier if it is a threat, to be completely honest.
Alright. So. I'm really just here trying to help her. What's Oriana? So, yeah, what line of questioning we got? We already talked about stuff. Got that.
Sounds like wriggling in their seat.
I don't like that look. Like, cause like you're looking top down.
I can't change it now anyway, so if you could.
Oh, wait, you can't.
No, because like my one of the buttons is in front of it. It just wants to open up the button for conditions.
Yeah, hold on. I saw it for a split second.
Oh, can I just control Z?
Just kill this Silas.
Yeah, I got you.
Thanks.
I got you.
Hey, what's up? How's it going?
I hate you. I can't stand you. You're terrible. I don't want to be here. You caused this. I can't believe you. They just start lamenting, just ranting about how this is all your fault.
Just like, hey, bitch, motherfucking bitch, piece of shit, bitch.
they're ranting like a toddler who just got dressed and didn't want to wear clothes.
What the fuck?
What?
Oh, God.
Amber, help!
What?
Look, what I got the tied fuck up did you... I got tied up in Samuel's stupid bit.
Well, it's your own fucking fault for siding with Samuel.
I'm not even siding with Samuel.
Me. I don't want to be here.
Did he drag you up here?
I was in my room. So he dragged me out of there.
I'm not concerned about you, Silas.
I was going with the bit and then it backfired on me. That's to be fair.
Well, you reap what you sow. She walks into this room.
Amber, wait, no, this wasn't my fault. Help, please.
I'm coming back out. Shut up.
Oh.
Are you getting your lockpick tools to pick them out of it or something?
I'm not fucking lockpicking you guys out. Get yourselves out. What is happening? She says, looking at Samuel. They're under arrest. For what? Impersonating an officer.
Okay. Oh, come on.
And,
cat crimes. Oh, they got catnip.
Yeah. They had catnip. Yeah. That's exactly why
that's arrested illegal.
In the first place. Yeah.
It's an illicit drug.
So this is like shaking their head violently.
What is it, class A drug?
She squints her eyes at Samuel. You were coming up here to ask about me, weren't you? No. Two of them say no and two of them say yeah.
I mean, it's a fair assumption considering the situation.
Let them out. Do you have the bail money? She stabs them in the chest. Officer down. I'm just fucking with him. He pulls out the knife and begins healing himself.
How good was the stab?
Vengeful.
Vengeful. Excellent. Lots of emotion in that one.
the others begin fading away.
Fuck.
Ow. Ow.
We still have the neon yellow handcuffs on us.
Oh no, absolutely. She's just trying to just... He begins like undoing all the handcuffs. The handcuffs are physical. So...
She does. You know what? She wants to try breaking them once because she says she could, and also it's part of the bit.
Yeah, sure. Roll me your strength, raw strength.
Just raw strength. Watch as they have like a trap.
That's in. That. That that's how.
Oh
that's how
god, that's so fitting for the bit though.
there are rules for manacles, which are basically handcuffs on
yeah,
breaking out of
like
them.
DC, like a high DC or something, because manacles.
It's like DC like 15 or some dumb shit, which is not what the DC would be for breaking out of handcuffs, by the way.
That's entirely achievable. She just rolled a 1.
No, I'm saying it'll be way harder. Like, people think it's like, oh, dude, handcuffs are just so easy to break out of. Yeah, they're fucking zip tie ones, and you know what you do for zip tie cuffs? You burn through them by cutting them against themselves and your shoelace, baby.
Yeah.
There's a fun fact for you, by the way.
Yeah.
But, like, it's not just... You can't just break cuffs. Like, fucking movies have, like poisoned people's minds on that. Yeah,
somehow she has gotten them more securely around this.
Now they're digging into your wrist. Should've just waited. Oh, my bad. Should've just waited. He undoes them.
Thank you.
Yeah, alright. There you go.
Somehow they're fuzzy and still dig into your wrists.
You found like there's like a groove of metal that the fur hangs out on, and you manage to find it and cut yourself against it.
Oh my god.
Kind of a dumb move.
Yeah, pretty dumb.
Like following someone to come arrest someone who did nothing wrong.
What do you mean? Cops do that all the time.
Yeah, they're dumb.
Got some social commentary for ya. Shut up. Shutting up. She looks at... Amber looks at you, says, I talked with Varric.
Yeah. Yeah. How'd it go?
He didn't have much input on it, same for Zajar. I mean... She shrugs. Everything's so weird these days, I'm not surprised. Life is full of many mysteries, Amber. Shut the fuck up. We're behind this. You can assume now that Samuel, when he talks, he's like peeking over like the couch, the couch chair. So he's a harder target.
I don't think I'll have much to.
Oops, sorry.
No, go ahead.
No, it's just, is it any weirder than everything else that we've been through?
Roll me a persuasion at disadvantage.
Hey, can I get Bardic, or are you just gonna hold on to that?
I'm just gonna hold on to it.
Thank you. Persuasion, disadvantage. Let me click the button. Oh, wait, no, he has guidance, technically. Kind of, maybe.
You don't know guidance for Samuel, yeah.
That's persuasion. Not persuasion. Perception, which would have been wrong.
No, isn't it persuasion?
God. Yeah.
It
is
persuasion.
No, I meant to press persuasion. I almost pressed perception.
And y'all are fresh out of inspos. Wait, no, you're not. Wait, I gave like a fucking wave of them. Wait.
Wait, you did. I'm out of mark it on my sheet. I didn't forget to mark it on my sheet. I did mark it on my sheet. Would 15 be the DC? I don't know if 15 would be the DC. I just re-roll an advantage. Don't press...
Well, re-roll disadvantage.
Yeah, that's what I meant to say.
Same number.
3 points better.
Technically true.
It's double digits now. That wasn't with the inspiration.
Yeah, you asked, like, is it any weirder than any other stuff? I don't fucking know what you guys have been up to.
Well, you know what given we were the doing beforehand.
For however truthful that is, she says, looking at Amber. Or not Amber, fuck. Amber says, looking at us.
It was a little exaggerated, but. To be fair, it was a performance.
Yeah.
If you want the whole story, I'm more than willing to give it.
I'm sure you are, but I have other things to do.
Fair enough.
She just holds up, like, the shrunken head. I need to go talk to someone.
Let me hold you.
Gotta come along? No. She opens the door, throws it open, slams it shut, and you guys immediately hear a lock.
Sounds like winces, like, oh, my mother would be furious about that if this was the real house.
Well, luckily, it's not. Yeah, that room was burned down.
So it starts sobbing.
Well, shit.
Think I'm safe?
You're never safe.
I don't know.
But it's from you, I'm probably safe. Oh, wait. What if I, listen through the wall?
Yeah, I'm sure she'll love that.
Definitely not. He peeks out. Trust or something.
He peeks out. You guys haven't really figured it out yet, have you?
What, they don't care?
Care?
No. That I'm trying to piss her off.
I see. Have fun then. Why the fuck is he trying to piss her off?
Probably to emotionally overcharge her so she stops putting up defenses all the time.
You guys can roll inside if you guys want.
Sure.
Don't have that, but I do have this. I
do the mid. Thing.
Mid.
Not mid, right? Yeah, not
no.
mid.
No, not mid.
Very not mid.
You guys wouldn't get guidance because your only source would be ironic. I'll give you
service guidance. Why not? Mostly because of Kensai.
Oh, you also had guidance.
Oh, I'll gladly throw in a guidance. What's a guidance? There's a guidance. It's slightly better.
Oh. Yeah. Oh.
You guys think about, why is he? And it's like, oh, overcharging Amber's emotions. Yeah, that's not to your guys' benefit. You guys know Amber. She can be stubborn and hateful until the moment she's dead and then beyond, probably. You guys think on it. You guys talk back and forth about, why is he? And it's just like, da-da-da.
Do we? Because it's... Do you want to go in this room? Because she could just follow you in that room.
Yeah. Well, eventually, but...
The reason Samuel is antagonizing Amber so much is so that you guys can scapegoat him. If you side of Amber against him, you get better points with Amber. That's why.
Chad.
He knows he can get away with it. He can take a dagger. You guys can't. Well, I mean, yes, you can, but in this emotional part, that's the problem. He already is hated by Amber. He doesn't mind. The whole point of him helping you guys is that you guys also hate him. That hasn't exactly been the case so far, unfortunately.
He's too goofy.
He's too goofy, and you guys latched onto him. The wrong way, though.
Mm-hmm.
But there's still room yet. Yeah, he's behind his cupboard.
Of only conversation at times, so it's like, okay.
I think gladly Silas will exclaim, "Alright, get out!"
What do you mean? I'm not in here.
Out!
You're very, very in here.
No, he's gets back into the corner. You ain't taking me alive.
I'll take you down.
Is this like a bookcase?
I just GM rolled this, but she got a nat 20 perception.
I don't think she needed it. Is this like a bookcase?
It's like a closet.
Is it movable?
To a degree, but as you guys are deciding what to do with him, she stabs him through the floor.
Oh god,
my cherry! Oh god, oh god!
What? Why are you like
ask questions?
I don't.
You see his pants now have a slight hole in where the buttocks is.
Stab you in the butt! Serves you right.
I was aiming for your face, you crouching cretin.
Oh, that actually probably would have been a really good stab limb, actually.
Ooh, you owe me dinner! She looks through the hole that she's now made, the line of the dagger pierce, and she stares daggers at him. We could reschedule. You guys hear her moving on the other side. What are you guys doing?
Well, I was trying to get him out of here.
He was kind of spying. Like, the second he had the opportunity to sneak away to try and listen to what you were saying.
Of course he did.
That's so fucking high. Jesus.
My god.
And she gets the guidance from Samuel. She just stares at all of you for a bit. Amber is smart. Remember that. She is pretty smart. Socially and otherwise.
So she figures out what he's trying to do?
Yes. She's trying to discern if you guys can figure out what he's trying to do.
The instant we tried to use it. God damn
it. Yeah, it took too long. No, I'm not saying, like, from the moment you discovered it to the moment of using it. I'm saying, you guys, like, it's been all the time you've known him. Do you find it fun to play the fool, Samuel? A little bit. Why? That's what you sound like? Did you really think I sounded like that my entire existence? No, I don't actually always sound like that.
He'd probably been killed as a baby.
Yeah, that's racist.
This is fucking intense.
Am I inaccurate?
I'll have you know.
Mm-hmm.
I am not a goblin.
Did I say goblin?
No, you didn't. Anyways,
to be a goblin.
unless I'm three goblins stacked on top of each other.
That's just anyways. Stupid.
So what was all this? Just a ploy? Ploy has such a negative connotation behind it. No, not a ploy, not as such. I think more stress release. This was stress release? Did you enjoy stabbing me? Okay, yeah, and I'll fucking do it again right now. If it makes you feel any better. She thinks about it for a sec? No. Because then you'll like it.
I sense I've made a mistake.
That was energy.
I get the feeling that you'd like it. I certainly don't like being stabbed, but I like being a stress release for you. Why? What do you mean, why? I thought you said I wasn't worth it. No, I mean... No more so than anyone else. What do you mean? Do you... What am I saying? You probably don't. My saint. The person I serve. Angel Saint Leon Tacitus. Used to revile... All mortals. Did you know that? No. Well, now you do. He reviled all mortals for all the wretched, wretched things out there. They are bound to their nature. You cannot blame the wind for blowing or the water for being wet. It is in a fiend's nature to be tricksy, a fae's nature to lie, a demon's nature to be malevolent. That's just what they are. But man, mortals, we can match their evil and then some, but why? We're not bound by a nature of cruelty or deception. And yet we still do it. We match the evil of the beyond and beat it out of human stubbornness.
Like walking into a sand vortex.
Like walking into a sand vortex. So, you're not really doing a good job of making him sound good. He's not good, I wouldn't say. And I don't think he would either. No, that's not the point I'm trying to get at. The point I'm trying to get at, Amber, is he's called the Redeemer. He was the only saint to fall to evil, and he is the only one to come back from it after a long time. Do you know why? Because he got redeemed? Yes. But do you know what revelation made him redeemable? I'm assuming you're going to tell us. Love, Amber. His goddess is love. Mortaldom's love. Our love. Not romantic, not necessarily platonic. A love for all. For all the wickedness mortals are. Untethered by natures, except one of death. We are also capable of great good. Of goodwill. Of charity. Of compassion. And sometimes it might take a second chance. And sometimes it might need a third, four, five, 20, a league of them. I know that is maybe not the best mantra for you to hear. I know you are deservedly self-driven. It is charity you will be offering such to give, he gestures at you two, another chance. I'm not doing do-overs. I didn't say do-overs. I said chances. The past is the past. When children squabble, when siblings say goodbye to each other for potentially decades, the last words they said to each other might be the last. You cannot change the past. But what we can do is try to move forward and meet in the middle. Can I stab you? Certainly. She stabs him right in the shoulder. Oh, right. Scraping the bone on that one. He pulls out the knife and gives it back to her. You know, all that talk about heartbroken Alicia, it makes me wonder if you're an Aquae Burn Bear Virilius. To love is to suffer. For one another. She looks at the dagger, which still has his blood on it. It drips every now and again. She's deep in contemplation. Silas, that expression she had when you guys were returning back, or the impetus that caused you guys to turn back, she said immediately, I need to go talk with Varric. It goes across her head again. Her face, rather. Whatever revelation or realization or notion that entered her head to cause that turnaround enters it once again. She sighs. I'm such a fucking idiot. She looks up from the dagger at you two. You guys want to take a stab at him?
Oh, certainly.
Oh, gods. At least let me heal first. Fine.
Fine.
He begins immediately healing the wound that she just gave him. Again, golden light shoots out from his hands, and you guys can see a series of bright lights underneath his arm sleeve, as well as trailing across his back to the other arm. All right. Just not the head.
What do you got? With a face.
Flourish, Silas will pull out their rapier. I use it so often, so inoften. I don't use it,
Amber,
so I've
heard... Amber was offering her dagger, if that changes your consideration.
Oh, that's exactly what I was going to ask.
Oh.
Go for it.
Yeah, Silas will take the dagger.
Her plus three dagger.
And give him a good stab.
Where do you stab him?
I stab him. I stab him in the heart, like that area.
Okay. Yeah, you stab him in the heart area, and he just holds on to the, like, as you stab him, you let go of the boy, let it sit there, and he just begins breathing heavily. Like someone entering frigid cold water. Okay. Nice spot, good for assassinations. He begins pulling out the blade and has his fingertips at the wound, and he's healing it as he's pulling it out so as to not cause any potential heart problems. Oh, I would say you're at least giving me good practice for healing others. Yay.
Yay.
You're welcome, I guess.
He gives it back to Amber, and she just checks the blood on it and looks at you, Oriana. She doesn't turn her head. Her eyes just flitter over to you.
Just dart up. I mean, sure, if she's offering, she'll take a dagger. So I know as like a short, as part of a short rest, she could like make a weapon her kensei weapon. So she's, I'm not asking if I could do that, but can I like, she just wants to get a feel for this dagger, you know?
Understand. You can spend a key point to try to do it in a similar manner as when you were doing in the sandstorm.
Yeah, absolutely.
It doesn't connect you to it, it just gives you like a, the corpus is like a perception check on it, but like in a key way, I guess.
Advanced perception check.
It's yeah. It's surprisingly mundane, if that makes sense.
It
like doesn't. There are like in this world, you can mass produce magic items. This is one such. So it doesn't have a cool legacy or story behind it. It is a weapon for killing. As dark as that sounds, looks at American industrial complex.
Does it give the sense of like, because it's like mass produced, is it from like not a corporation per se, but like people whose business it is for war? Maybe not war, actually, because that's a dagger.
In your experience, you don't have access to possible weapons all the time, but to your knowledge, yes, but this one is scrubbed clean of any identification.
That's intentional.
Welcome to Cutthroat's Keep.
Yeah, she just kind of like holds it in that way, like where you have like the point pressed against your finger, you're just kind of like spinning it. Huh.
Go on, stab him already.
Like, well, what if I don't want to stab him? In the middle of saying that, she stabs him. Just somewhere between the ribs.
You know, I'll be honest, stabbing him really didn't actually make me feel that much better.
Well, that's why all of you guys and me are different.
It's a bond.
Yes, it is.
He pulls it out and does the same trick healing.
How often can you heal?
I'm not going to disclose that information for my own safety. There is a limit, though. Yes, there is. But again, if you guys keep doing that, I'll start fighting back.
I feel like we've had a discussion.
We did, earlier.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Excuse me, I need to take a quick seat. Well, go on, then. Get through your feelings. I'll be here. Shut up.
Get through your feelings.
I didn't say I would stop antagonizing you, did I? I hate you. A lot of people do. Join the club.
I mean, from the looks of it, it could be a lot worse.
Fine. She points at you, Sias. I forgive you.
Thank you.
I can respect following through on your convictions, and I can respect taking care of your family. She looks at you, Arata. I don't know if I forgive you yet. I don't hate you as much.
I get that because there's a lot to forgive. And I've probably been not great at, I don't know, explaining myself. I'm trying to avoid saying excusing myself, because I shouldn't give excuses.
It's just what they are, aren't they?
Yeah, I suppose. Look, I am sorry for everything, and I could go through a list of things, but we'd probably be here for like fucking 3 hours. But I am
okay. Here's the thing. I don't care about you guys and your reasons and your excuses or your whatever. Alright? At the end of the day, you guys promised me that you would help me in the north, and what'd you guys do? Yeah, she gestures at you, says your family was in danger. But we knew that going north.
I didn't grasp that fully.
Well, welcome to the wake-up call.
That's exactly what it was.
And to be fair, I kind of was a starting point of pulling us all down here in the first place, so we kind of went the opposite direction.
Yeah, and what did I do when that happened? I came down and I helped you guys. Is it so wrong for me to ask it for it back?
Yes, I was getting to that. It's just, when we had the opportunity to assist you, we didn't.
And then Redain left, because he followed his own path. I can respect that. She looks at you, says, you followed your own path, I can respect that. You followed your path, Orianna, I can respect that. I don't give a shit about the stuff you guys want to do, but I can respect that you guys had the guts to actually fucking do it. But it proves to me that you guys didn't have the guts to stay true to your word. You're fickle. I don't need fickle people helping me. I want people I can trust. People I can rely on. I mean, fuck's sake. Samuel is a piece of shit. Duly noted. Shut up. But I can trust him to be that piece of shit. Yes, you can. Shut up. Noted. I'm sorry, guys. Sort of. I don't know if I'm gonna stay.
What can we do in the meantime to help for you going forward if you do leave, then?
Stay out of my way.
All right.
There's not much help you guys can offer me.
Then we're here. You guys
have a lot of sort connected to the Five and everything.
You guys don't know anything about the Five. You guys aren't sneaky enough to do the stuff I do, and you guys aren't willing to come north with me to help. So you guys can offer all you want. There's nothing of value you guys bring to the table. And that's that.
Why?
I already talked to Varric about it.
Right. Did he mention, like, the plans that he was making for us already?
Wow, what amazing plans. Okay, they're good plans, I guess.
But they don't help you.
The only thing that might help me is the Aspirant path.
I was going to ask if he mentioned that.
He did. Being honest, I don't know if I want to do the Aspirant path.
What's driving you away from it?
What I saw. I told him I'd vote. It was bad.
Bad? Like, you saw a premonition of the... This isn't my place, sorry.
You want to know what I saw?
If you're willing to share it, I would.
She gestures at Silas, like, yeah, that.
But I'm not gonna... Not that I could, but I'm not gonna force you to.
I saw a kid, maybe a couple years older than me. How's that a kid if he's older? Shut the fuck up.
She's trying to get through a thing.
And you... immediately begin seeing the virtue of having a common enemy.
Oh, I broke my cord.
Samuel was always there to be the hateable guy. Just like Joffrey in Game of Thrones. I saw a guy no more older than me. On fire. But he wouldn't even feel it. He was just sitting in a fucking... I don't know, like a table? Like a surgical table? Like an autopsy table. Dressed in fancy kit. The likes of which I've never even seen before. The closest thing I would say comes close to are the Seekers and Slayers. He just kept talking at me. Talking to me. He heard me.
Did they have a ring? Point at the one Amber has like that.
She looks at it. Yeah. Where'd you get this from?
The Dreaming City. Well, I didn't get it. It was America, Zal, and them. They ran into someone in there that was... I can only assume from the same group, because the description you gave is similar enough.
Maybe they're not so useless after all. She says that half jokingly. She doesn't genuinely think they're useless. But for her purposes, for her agenda, they are sort of useless.
Yeah. Not useless as a whole, just useless for what she's doing.
Yeah.
It's like asking quantum physics questions to a lumberjack. It's like he's not going to have the answer, but he can still cut down a tree.
Yeah. Huh. Interesting. The guy just
realized, I said Dreaming City. Did he have any reaction to that? I don't know if I could read his fucking reaction.
He seems fine. Eh.
Weird. Irrelevant. Continue what you were saying.
He sounded so condescending. Sort of reminds me a bit of Samuel. Oof. He just said oof in the background. Not like that. Just, I don't know. Like, not condescending, arrogant, but like he knew what he was talking about. Like an adult talking down to a child.
Which I imagine you don't take too kindly to.
Depends. It depends on if I think they earned it. As she says, think they earned it, she looks at you, Silas.
Silas looks back. They seem surprised, but thinking about it, I don't think they would seem surprised.
She did ask you guys way back about what determines if someone can be your mentor or not. And Sejara said something along the lines of time buys you wisdom, or, you know, wisdom through time is because of perspective. Wisdom when you're young is a result of suffering. I honestly wanted to punch him. He was... I don't know if you guys ever did sports growing up. Something like a really overpushy coach. All the advice, all the do this, do that to become better, but just because the advice is right doesn't mean it sits right.
You don't want to hear it at the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But in hindsight, usually that advice rings true.
Usually. Yeah. The things he told me.
So.
Hmm?
It doesn't sound like the conversation you had was that terrible. I'm not sure I understand what makes it. It sounds really bad from what you were saying, but from my understanding, I'm not sure I understand what made it so.
It's what he said that made it bad.
I see.
What did he say?
That sometimes someone has to pick up all the slack, all the broken pieces. Someone has to trailblaze. Sometimes, even that's not enough. Sometimes you do it too well. He was pretty insistent that you can let the world win. You can live on its terms. Or you can win on yours. He called me out. He called me out. He says, oh, something always comes up. Why don't you just cut out some time? Which sounds so fucking pompous and inconsiderate. But I get the feeling that he said it because he thought I can do it. Because he did it. So that's what I'm wondering now. I can go with you guys. I can cut my own time out.
But it comes at the cost of not making progress for what you specifically want.
It could. It might not. That's what he was talking about. And Varric talked about it too. Putting in extra effort where it counts so you get more payout in the right places. And that might buy you a moment or two to breathe. But I know they're both similar in one specific aspect. She looks up at you guys. It all starts with a plan. We can't just keep reacting. We can't be the pawns in someone else's plan. We have to have our own.
I think a lot of us are starting to realize that.
And we're actually taking steps towards it.
Both of you make a persuasion check.
Okie doke. I will give Oriana Bardic.
Oh god, can you sell your D10 from earlier?
Fuck yeah.
I feel like it's probably been longer than 10 minutes, but eh.
God, thank
hey!
You.
Hey!
Hey!
Nice nat. Nice natty, bro.
Oh, love me some natty light, bro.
I was so close. I was so close.
Did you draw your bardic?
I did not. But I mean, I was close to like a...
Oh, a nat?
Nat.
Yeah, you're one off.
Yeah.
You're one off.
I'll use the bardic because I don't know if I'm gonna have a scenario to use it after this. Because it's definitely probably been over 10 minutes.
With all the bullshit that happened of you guys getting quote unquote arrested by Samuel, like fake Samuel, probably it's been longer
Samuel
than
10 minutes. Yeah. Two other fake
but if you'll let me use it here, I appreciate it. So I'll use it. So.
Wait, is it
nice? That's what I get for being appreciative. Fuck you.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Yeah, you got touch 31.
I did.
Oh, wait, no, you have a D10 from...
Yeah, Evelina.
Yeah.
Evelina, that's what I thought. Okay.
Girlfriend privilege.
I mean, fair. You put in the work.
She corks her eye about that. Oh, yeah? Well, that's good to hear. These you guys are running around with a bunch of fucking headless chickens. That's good.
Still feels like it, sometimes, but...
You gotta carve out your own piece in it.
Yeah, exactly.
And we're working on it.
You guys could hear Samuel, who has snuck over behind you guys. Second Jesus. Chances. And for once, Amber doesn't tell him to shut up, because by perspective, she totally saw him sneaking up behind you guys.
I think Silas is too preoccupied, so they jump again. They're like, can you stop?
She just smirks at that.
Can you just not? I'm gonna put my back against this wall.
I'll trust Samuel to not do it again. He's going to do it again, though.
You're a fool. Nah,
not bad. They high five.
Oh, how the tables have turned.
Alright, I'm going back to my bed. Keep seeing you guys' suspect on. No. I'll think on staying if you guys actually are changing. But I swear to the gods, I'm not giving thirds. I don't care what fucking Samuel says. I'm not giving third chances.
I really, really hope the majority of us do not do wrong by you a third time.
One more thing. She, looks at you guys very pointedly. No telling this to Anushka.
Not a word.
She looks at you very, very pointedly. Corks an eyebrow.
Just holds up hands placatively. It's like, hey.
Swear it.
I swear thrice on my name. She waits to hear like a clicking noise.
Yeah, you hear a
clicking noise. I feel legally obligated to say I am not an elder power, but I do serve one, so you're like half actually in on that. As a witness, as I'm a witness, just so you know.
Yeah, there's a reason that I made sure to say it while you were here.
Okay, just making sure.
It sucked not having to tell Anushka, but also, do it.
Easy, keep your mouth shut.
I mean, it's the same deal as when I'm observing you guys to see how you guys are. She gestures at you, Silas. I mean, you heard my rant earlier.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna give you the free fucking hint, Oriana. If Lonin says stuff, remember what she fucking says. If Lonin confides in you what she's about, what she wants to do in life, fucking remember it. It's her fucking birthday. Memorize that shit.
Oh god, I don't know when the birthday. Wait, hold on. I don't know if she cares about birthdays. I should find out about that.
Maybe she doesn't. She's twins, Ian, but still. My point is, remember it. Don't do what Anushka did.
I know she's into tea reading.
So fucking lame.
Hey.
I'm just saying. You're into the girls you're into. Whatever. All right. Deal. Pack sealed. She says, leaning, looking at Samuel, who's like, thumbs up. Like, yep.
Yeah, we're good. Like, sure. Wait, she had her hand held out, right?
No, she was just pointing at Samuel.
Pointing at Samuel. Okay.
And one last thing to make things even. She punches both of you. She, like, specifically aims to, like, dead arm you. I'm just gonna roll, like, I can't use the knife, because that has the plus three on it.
You know, you're the second person to punch me after I talk to them!
This is a bad habit.
I would say it would go in order of, like, because she was just standing here. Yeah. Like this. So, Oriana, yeah, that fucking hurts. Silas, I think that still beats your AC, so it definitely hurts still, but probably not.
Yeah.
You guys are both dead arm, though.
Ow, why? How are you? Why is that such a good throw? Ow.
It's not a throw.
No, it was a good
because
punch.
I know where to punch. Because I know where to aim.
My hand's tingling.
My hand's
tingling. All right, child.
And with that, that's where we end session. Quite damn. A while overtime. But next week, we can at least start going to the time skip stuff and making substantial progress.
Thank
quickly.
Christ. This party was great and all, but it overstayed.
Yeah.
I agree on that. But once I was in, I was like, we can't. In fairness, it was supposed to end way earlier, but someone had to
do shit.
Someone. Great for Mandrax. Can't imagine who it was.
He's not even here to properly receive scolding. It's not scolding.
It sort of is. Yeah. I can finally sit.
Oh, God. And guys,
what?
The most important part about finishing this party up, next session,
you get new clothes.
Yeah, I can start using
LSD. Hey, let's go. It'd be good because, like, we're down people today anyway, so. Mm-hmm. Alright, sitting up. Yeah, I don't know if Amber is staying with you guys. Like, yeah, you guys are on better terms now, but that doesn't mean she's staying.
Yeah.
As Samuel put it, and as Amber has described, like, you guys just don't flow. You don't mesh in the same way.
It's almost like she's a criminal, and we're not.
No, it's not that. It's just a matter... Well, the thing is, that's the interesting conundrum here. She vibes with some of you, but not all of you.
Yeah, it's because you're not a Machiavellian fuck like Redain was.
Yeah, it's because you're
his words online. Shit. His words online. But yeah, that is sort of the bottom line of it. Like, keep in mind who she respects. She respects Alessander. She respects Sajar. And what do they both do? They both are very driven people. In fairness, Alexander hasn't had, like, a large-scale drive, like, to cross provinces and stuff like that.
No.
But you were driven when it came to Delvet, and she saw how driven you were for Delvet when you desperately asked to help fix him. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Also, to be fair, he is kind of planning to at least head over to the exchange with something, so that's still pretty far distant.
Yes, that is also true, but not that Amber has any insight into that, right?
That's right.
Versus Oriana is reactive to Scavola, Sias is reactive against the Black Force, etc., etc. I guess you probably would have gotten insights on Alexander when you were looking for the blue moss at the party crasher operation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's, yeah, she has insights on being a driven person, which is what Amber herself is like, right?
Right.
Which is why she ditched you. My bad. You guys ditch her, not the other way around. I guess Alexander, you're queen on that because you weren't there for the initial agreement.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, she's like, yeah, I'm going north. I'm going to do shit.
You can't hate me. I'm too new.
See,
you can't hate me. You don't know me.
I think the other part of it is, like, you guys picked Amber, which means that you are more consigning with her agreement. Like, I was like, yeah, I'll help you guys. You guys need to help me.
We did pick Amber. Yeah.
You did pick Amber. Kasai was going to do her own destiny, and Lambert was in a state of depression.
Yeah.
So what do you call today's session?
The party's over.
Party crash.
Where the heart was.
Crashed?
Why is it not letting me select those choices?
Crash down.
We got where the heart is, where the heart will be, and where the heart was.
Hey.
Because it's over now, and we don't have hearts anymore.
What
that's...
the heart wants.
Ooh.
What the heart...
I like that. What the heart wants.
Who's the heart?
Why's the heart?
How is the heart?
Heart doesn't matter.
Okay, turn off grid.
But how's the heart?
Samuel's like, it got stabbed.
So this is like, I don't feel that great about it.
Yeah, does he still feel pain?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, he can feel pain, yeah.
I didn't know if that was also a neck or what. Damn, you guys are fucked up. You suck.
Yeah, no, yeah,
100%, it's only because...
It was a pretty evil thing to do, like, honestly. Like, it was outright a pretty evil thing to do. Like, put that in the recap next week that you actually stabbed Samuel.
Yeah, I said that's what bad after.
Amber was just like, hey, you guys want to stab? And it's like, I feel I should say yes, but I don't want to.
But you did. You said yes, and then you did it.
So this
yeah,
is like,
I still chose.
Yeah.
I still made a choice.
Wait, this doesn't feel great. Why do you do this?
You got blinded by the lights.
Yeah. I'm blind. No, I can't see.
Can't see shit.
It's a remix of a song. Well, not a remix, just...
by the clown shoes.
Yeah. But yeah, you guys are now sworn to secrecy from Anushka. Or to Anushka from from Anushka, yeah. From Anushka. Yeah.
We cannot
yeah.
tell Anushka bullshit.
In Anushka.
Yeah.
Not inside Anushka.
No one was suggesting that.
He said in Anushka.
No. I didn't.
Don't fucking start gaslighting me.